I'm very delighted to be here to address you on this special occasion of the conferment of the President's NYSC Honors Award on these worthy young men and women who have diligently served the nation through the National Youth Service Corps. I'm especially pleased by the fact that we are gathered here to honor a time-tested tradition, the recognition and celebration of young Nigerians who, by hard work, innovation, sacrifice, and selfless service, have distinguished themselves as NYSC members in various states. I commend both the management and staff of the Ministry of Youth and Sports and the NYSC for reviving this noble ideal of recognizing and rewarding excellence. The National Youth Service Corps is an indisputable national heritage established in 1973 by His Excellency and Elder Statesman, General Yakubu Gowon, who himself at the time was just 39 years old, to promote national integration and cohesion. Beyond this, the program has become an important complement to national development by making available manpower to meet Nigeria's requirements in education, in health, in infrastructure, development, and many other areas. The NYSC has, from the beginning, been about opportunities. Opportunities for young Nigerians to serve, to earn a living, to travel, to see, to learn about their country, and to go beyond their comfort zones, and also to build lifelong friendships. The important roles that these young people, especially members of the NYSC, have played in ensuring the peaceful conduct of the 2015 elections and the 2019 general elections, and several elections in between, offer clear evidence that when positively engaged in nation building and national activities, our country stands to gain tremendously from its brilliant set of young people. Point, I invite you all to rise and observe a minute's silence in honor of those core members who, in their service to this nation, lost their lives. May their souls rest in peace.
Amen.
Please sit. Me to speak briefly on three core ideas that may be useful to remember here, especially as this is a government of Nigeria's present and its future, especially you, the brightest and best who are being celebrated today. One, and the first of these, is that it is the exceptional individuals in society who are the true builders of institutions and nations. These exceptional individuals like yourselves are not necessarily those from the wealthiest homes or the most fortunate circumstances. Indeed, they may be from the most humble circumstances, and they may not even be the most academically successful of their peers. But they are the young men and women who somehow know that true greatness comes from serving others and from serving one's community. The second is that it is the vision, the innovation and hard work of just one person that will make a difference in the life of a community or a nation. We have seen in the outstanding work of many of you who are here today that indeed your innovation, your hard work, just you alone, by your own vision, you've been able to contribute so much and so profoundly development of the communities that you serve. So just one person can make a substantial difference in the life of the community and the life of the people of any nation. The third is that enduring individual success is a function of the courage and resilience that we bring to our lives. I was challenged here by the remarkable courage of those core members who suffered various accidents while in service, and they belong to the group that have been described as the Hope Alive group. The fact that these young men and women have gone through these harrowing personal injuries, but they are still determined to engage the future with hope and confidence, is proof that they will experience the joys of great success and fulfillment in their lives, and that their future is bright. But it is a greater lesson to all of us that whatever the setbacks that we may experience in life, it is to be used as a stepping stone. It should not be seen as the end. It should not be seen as the darkening of our lives. Indeed, it may well be the beginning of even a much greater future. To all of today's honorees, let me make it clear that you are not just the future of our country, but you are also its present. You must all see yourselves as the leaders that you are. But leadership, as you know, comes with responsibility and continual sacrifice. The successes you have achieved and are being rewarded for today should inspire you to even greater feats in your various spheres of influence. I therefore charge you all to continue to be the light for others to follow, while seeing yourselves as lifelong ambassadors of the NYSC. In line with our policy of encouraging and rewarding excellence amongst our youth, I hereby announce the immediate employment in the automatic scholarships. Selection committee for the painstaking and rigorous process that brought these young men and women to national limelight. The entire nation owes a huge debt of gratitude to the managers of the NYSC and the successive batches of core members for the patriotic zeal with which you have collectively implemented the cardinal programs of the scheme over the past 4 years and over the past 4.5 decades. As 40 and a half years. May I also pay tribute to the founding father of the NYSC and all of those who work with him. It is those ideals that you knew would serve our country well, would serve the youth of our country well, that we see today, so many years after you founded this great scheme, being demonstrated by these young men and women who were not even born, they were not even an idea at the time when this was launched. I thank you very, very much and congratulate and commend you. I also commend the great efforts of the Ministry of Youth and Sports Development and the NYSC. The hard work they've really put into this to create jobs through skills acquisition and other youth entrepreneurship development initiatives. The Federal Executive Council recently approved the 2019-2023 National Youth Policy presented by the Ministry of Youth and Sports Development for implementation by the Ministry and all stakeholders. This is to enable the NYSC build on its achievements all stakeholders must discharge their statutory obligations as spelled out in the Enabling Act. I urge all states and local governments to give greater support to the scheme, especially through the provision and upgrade of permanent orientation camps, lodges for club members, and other welfare facilities. Once again, may I congratulate all the honorees on this well-deserved recognition and honor. The entire nation salutes your determination, your courage, your selfless service, your discipline and hard work. And this you've exhibited during all of your service years. God bless you all. God bless my dear.